This video is brought to you by Storyblocks Video. Hey guys, Yannick here for Cinecam.net and welcome to another Copycat Friday, a series where we recreate effects from famous movies and music videos. And today we are recreating the effect from Jane, Come. Lorenzo? Where are you? Lorenzo! 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 Damn guys, we really lost Lorenzo. This is not good. We need him here so he can help filming the explanation of the effect. Lorenzo! Oh, you're back, Lorenzo! Thank God!
I've seen things, horrible things.
Okay, get back to work now. Okay, now that Lorenzo is back from his shenanigans, we can start with the tutorial. But first, I would like to do a quick shout out to Storyblocks Video for sponsoring us. This is a video library which I very often use, for work and private videos. But you can find more than just videos on Storyblocks Video. It's also packed with effects, transitions, templates, animation, and so much more. There are hundreds of thousands of video assets you can download without additional fees. Click in the first link in the description below for more information. Now for the effect for this week, we chose to recreate something out of an older music video named Come, by the artist Jane. This music video is packed with effects and we had to choose one. Otherwise, this would be a very, very long video. And by seeing the intro, you already know which effect, of course. So without further ado, let's start the building montage. Yesterday, I tested the effect and I only used two C-stands and a green screen.
Dead a catch!
Look what Jordi took today. I think we overkilled it.
Totally not. Like I was saying, this here is very useful so that all of these poles right here won't glide and fall on the ground. So we're using everything today. This right here, very useful as well, because where else am I going to put my jacket on? There we go, we're making everything useful.
Like I said, two C stands and a green screen. Okay, we built everything, and now it's time to explain what we are going to use. First, a tripod with an invisible camera. That's an effect for another video. But we need a tripod because we need to match two shots, the green screen shot and the normal shot. And this is easier with a tripod. Next up are the green screens. We use two green screens because we need to create this opening so somebody can go through or back in. We use clamps on the back so that we can create this opening. Next up, is this big diffuser. We are using this because we are outside and the sun is too hard, so we need this diffuser to create soft lighting. And this you can see on this beautiful green screen. We need this diffuse light because the shadows can be hard on a green screen, otherwise you can't key it. The last thing we need is this black screen. We're gonna put it behind the green screen, so when a person goes through the hole in the green screen, they step into the black, into the void, you can say. Last but not least, the clothes you are wearing are also very important, because if they are too reflective, the key won't work that great. So, to make it yourself easier, wear something dark, something black. This won't reflect that much. Okay, that covers the setup that you need, but I forgot to explain one more thing. When everything is set up and you're ready to start shooting, you need to close the aperture of your camera. I would say something around f9 or 10 will do. We do this because we have two subjects that needs to be in focus at the same time and they aren't standing on the same line. Then it's time to make the shots with the green screen. Just film from a tripod and let the actor go through the green screen. Then when it's completely gone, you can either really carefully stop recording or let the camera just roll. It's very important that the camera doesn't move. Now move the green screen and the rest of the setup out of the frame. Then let the second actor stand on his place and film him doing his thing. And that are all the shots you need for this effect. Before we jump on Premiere Pro now, I would first like to show you guys something special. In December we reached 1 million subscribers and decided to do something for a charity active in Sri Lanka. Their main goal is improving the education for the kids there. And when seeing this, we immediately felt the connection with them and had to help. We did a fundraising asking all of our viewers to donate a small sum to a GoFundMe page. This money would then help with building schools or restoring them. And guys, you really came through. This week we received the first pictures from Sri Lanka, where they just placed a new part of a small school. They used the money to build it by local workers and the parents of the school kids. In the summer, a few people from here will go to Sri Lanka to help them more. We will also send a container full with educational materials with them. So if you want to contribute, the GoFundMe page is still open and you can find the link in the description below. Now it's time to jump into Premiere Pro. Import your two clips and create a new sequence. Then drag your clip without your green screen to the first track. The clip with the green screen can go on track number two. The first thing that we are going to do is remove the green screen. But before this, I want to show you a small hack to make the green key a lot easier. Open up Lumetri panel. If you can't find it, go up to the menu on top and select Window and enable the Lumetri panel. Inside the panel, you can open up the curves tab. This will give you different types of curves, but the only one we need is the hue versus saturation curve. Take the color picker tool and select the green. Now make the selection a little bit bigger and drag the point in the middle up. This will increase the saturation of the green, so don't overdo it. Okay, our green is super green now, which will make the key a lot easier. And it's time to remove it now. In the effects library, search for the Ultra Key effect and drag it to the green screen clip. In the effects controls, you can now take the color picker from the Ultra Key effect and select the green. This will remove the green from your shot. If you notice that the key isn't that good, you can always tweak it a little bit more in the settings until you get the perfect key. But if you still have some spill, add a new Lumetri effect to the green screen clip and place it underneath the Ultra key. With the HSL secondary, you can make a green selection from the top controls and then modify that green with the sliders below. I neutralized the green by adding magenta, decrease the saturation to get rid of the green, and finally, add a little bit of warmth to get natural skin tones back in the spill areas. Also, if you want, you can leave some shadow ripples on the green screen when opening up the hole. It can contribute to the effect as you're actually opening up the clip as a fabric. Now, being so close to the green screen doesn't make a green key easy. It makes it even very hard. But a few weeks ago, we started testing with BorisFX, and they have an awesome keying plugin called Primate Studio, which can really help here. If you want to know more about this plugin, there's a link in the description below. Okay, it's masking time. With the green screen clip selected, go up to the effects control panel and then under opacity property, you can select the pen tool and create a mask inside the green screen. However, you probably still have this line in the middle of your green screen, which can be keyed out. So create the mask on the right side of it so that the line is gone. But when Lorenzo comes in and steps inside the hole, he will step outside the mask and will be cut off. So we need to animate this mask. Search for the point where Lorenzo is still just inside the mask, and on this point, enable the animation for the mask pad. Then go frame by frame further in time and adjust the mask so that it follows Lorenzo's hand and thus opening up the hole in the clip. In the end, Lorenzo also closes this hole, so we need to animate the mask again there. But this time, let the mask go up with his hand so the hole is closed and disappears. Okay, now you have combined the two shots and they match perfectly. The only thing that is missing now is some kind of effect so that it really looks like the fabric of space is opened. Like some kind of ripple. And this we are going to create with the turbulent displace effect. Drag this effect from the effects library to the clip without the green screen on track number one. The effect will now warp the whole shot, not something we need. So create a mask within the turbulent displace effect, select the circle mask and adjust it so that it lies behind the hole. Also feather the mask enough, something between 40 or 50 will do. Next, it's time to change settings. First, set the displacement to bulge and then the amount to zero. Go to the point where Lorenzo starts opening up the hole and enable the animation for the amount. What you now can do is increase and decrease the amount while going further in time. Try to watch Lorenzo's movement and match it. When Lorenzo went through the hole, you can set the amount back to zero. And that is all there is to it. One more thing maybe. You can also add a fake handheld movement to everything if you want. Just select the clips, right click on them and select nest. Then drag a fake handheld movement preset from our preset pack to the nested sequence and voila. A super cool effect. And that was it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you, Storyblocks Video, for the support. And like always, stay creative.
Geef toe dat dat cool was wat ik net deed.
Ja, dat was cool, kom.
Kom, oké, goed.
Allee, dat doe ik klem neer.
Dat doe ik klem.